Rose, are you still here? Rose, if you hear me, come back up here for a minute. One of the things that we're gonna show in this mix of trailers, I don't know if you guys have ever heard about this, but Johnny did a cameo in a science fiction film called Stranded. Do you wanna talk about this, Rose? Are you willing to? All right, well, let's just say that Johnny was kind of roped into doing a cameo in a science fiction film as a favor to somebody. He had a great time with it. Not a lot of people have seen it. That's going to be shown within the trailers tonight. I think you guys are really going to dig that. So again, get your autographs because that line will be cut off at 9 o'clock. And at 9 o'clock, Rock and Roll High School will start. So thanks again for your support of the JRA and the Ramones. Earlier I was telling you guys a story about Johnny doing a cameo in a sci-fi film that Rose actually played an instrumental part in happening, and I just found out a minute ago she didn't even know. But now she does, and we're going to share that story with you. We're about to show a comp of about 20 minutes of some cool, fun 70s exploitation trailers. Amidst that is a clip from a sci-fi film. It was a Vincent Gallo film called Stranded. Vincent's also a good friend of Johnny's. And Rose, do you want to just kick things off, or do you need me to tee it up for you?
No, this I just found this out. So, I mean, I knew this horrible story of what I'd done. And making Johnny Ramone upset was always kind of scary. So Linda Ramone calls me and says, Rose, we need to go pick up a bear for Johnny. And I was like, a bear? What's that? Oh, a bear. So we go down to El Segundo to pick up an 8-foot taxidermied bear from a place that had mostly half taxidermy things. I borrow Vincent's Suburban, which is the biggest car I've ever driven, I have to say. We pull out of his house to go to El Segundo to get the bear, and promptly hear this terrible sound as I reverse. Linda can drive. And I've run over Vincent's mailbox, but also managed to gouge the entire length of the car with it.
Nice.
So that was awesome. I felt real good about that.
Class A driving.
Thank you. As it turns out, so I was like, well, I don't know what to do. I'll just go get the bear. So we go get the bear. It stinks like bear ass or whatever that is. And we get back, and I had to tell Vincent, which I was also terrified of. And as it turns out, it was in pristine condition. He was trading it in the next day. So he was so furious, and then Johnny felt bad, and then Johnny was also mad, though, and Vincent was going to charge him $15,000, and I tried to pay. Johnny wouldn't have it, and as it turns out, as I just found out, the trade-off was Johnny doing this this cameo, and now we get to see Johnny in celluloid. So, you know, all in all, the bear, the car, the mailbox, Vincent Gallo yelling at me, it's all worth it to see Johnny on film.
And it's a pretty bizarre cameo, so let's hear it for Rose, because had it not been for Rose smacking up Vincent's car, you would not see this shot of Johnny as the Space Hitler.
It's 298 days since the first manned mission to Mars. We're now going into orbit around the red planet.
Module cannot sustain the five of us. We're in the most unlivable place you can imagine.
How many can survive?
I don't want to die.
There's always a way to survive.
Look over there.
What's that? It
doesn't seem to be natural.
I don't know what it is.
It's just something weird.
Is it possible?
You haven't seen it.
There's air here. We could survive.
Our only chance is to reduce energy consumption to a minimum. We've already lowered the inside temperature of the module.
Okay, very well. Susanna, hope it works.
Any news on our rescue?
No. Bringing my journey home. I'm going to be leaving in 2 days. They've come up with an alternative trajectory back on Earth. I'm sorry.
Do they have any idea back on Earth why we crashed?
So far, only theories. Some quite intriguing ones, but only theories.
In what way?
Well, as you know, Mars has no planetary magnetic fields.
But it does have magnetic anomalies and localized gravitations. There's no satisfactory explanation for this.
Well, we've detected the strongest of these anomalies where you crashed at the bottom of the Marineris Valley. We're dealing with something so strong and localized that it could have very well have affected Velos OCR
oscillatus, and that's not all.
Go on.
There's something hidden under the fog. I don't know what it is.
It's just something weird. okay? Take a look at the photos. Take a look at the new photos and look at them carefully. I'm sorry, I have to go. I have a long journey back. Good luck.